This has nothing to do with diversity. It has to do with density. Density brings crime. That's when I compared it with Newark, because I know firsthand what happened in Newark. Therefore, I don't want Palm Coast to even come remotely comparable to Newark.
Palm Coast Vice Mayor Eddie Branchino equates multifamily housing or density with crime and has used the argument to back up his opposition to multifamily development in the city. But on WNZF's business report, Flagler County Sheriff Rick Staley, who has 50 years of law enforcement experience, gives his take.
I do not have empirical data to support that either way. It depends on the type of rental property. So if you had what would be known as HUD housing or Section 8 housing, then likely you're going to see increased crime there because that's the tenants that you're getting to some degree. Not all of them, but the bad ones give the rap to everybody. But, you know, it depends on the quality and it depends on the management. Even in Section 8 in HUD housing, it depends on the management. So in other words, if they have strict rules and if those renters that violate it or commit a crime, you evict them because you have a strong rental agreement. So if you have a weak manager, they don't care. If you don't care about your tenants or the property, then you're going to attract a certain clientele.
Early in his career, Staley tells WNZF he needed federal mortgage assistance.
I was a young cop at the time, and there was a federal program because we were paid so low that I actually had mortgage assistance from the federal government for the first, I don't know, couple of years. And my community was fine. That was a program, and I qualified for it. So that program gave me a helping hand up. The neighborhood that I was in had any criminal element to speak of just because my mortgage had one-third of the payment paid by the federal government under a program.
Hear the full interview with Sheriff Staley on the Business Report tomorrow morning right here on WNZF. This local news is a service of Flagler County's Toyota dealer, Beaver Toyota US 1 St. Augustine, here to wow you. On July 18th, a construction crew unearthed some human remains. Flagler County Sheriff Rick Staley has an update.
Sheriff's investigators, along with CSI and FDLE and the medical examiner's office, has been sifting through large dirt piles in this construction site and have recovered a few human skeletal bones and fragments. We've been working with the University of South Florida to determine the best way to uncover any human remains on this large construction site. The University of South Florida has extensive experience. They developed a system and special equipment to speed up the process. As a result, we have paused the dig, but will continue to guard the site with a deputy sheriff. And early next week, University of South Florida will join us in excavating.
Staley says he appreciates the support of all the agencies involved and that this is a labor-intensive operation, but they're determined to recover all pieces of human remains that can be located.
It's tough for everyone. It's tough for our city. It's tough for our residents. But I really seriously think we need to look for more cuts.
But Palm Coast City Councilman Ed Danko reluctantly agreed to keep the city's property tax rate at its current level of 4.6 mils. Despite the rate being unchanged, property values have soared nearly 20% due to inflation, so it equates to a tax hike for most.
I really want to urge everyone to start looking for some places to make some cuts, because that's what folks are having to do at home. And things have just gotten out of control, unfortunately. I know we have must-have things, our fire department, our police, EMTs, our roads, our water, but there are things we don't necessarily need.
Despite outlining must-haves, Danko didn't specify where he believes cuts could be made. City Council still has time to lower the tax rate for the coming year if it finds areas to tighten its belt. From the WNZF Newsroom, I'm Amy Cherry.
Palm Coast Tennis Center expansion lands a $729,000 county grant.
The money comes from Flagler County's Tourist Development Council. County Tourism Office Executive Director Amy Lukasik says the expanded center's attraction goes well beyond Palm Coast.
We are a support system for the city of Palm Coast. Their success is our success, and we have a vested interest regardless. When we have a tourism asset like this, we have the ability to tap into those event organizers even outside of their reach, so we would work hand in hand.
County Commissioner and Tourist Development Council Chair Dave Sullivan says he has concerns about the tourism aspect of this with other venues in the area.
We got to be very careful about making it any kind of exclusive facility that the normal residents, since a lot of this is money that's coming in one way or another from taxpayers, to be able to use it. So I'm okay with what we're doing right now, but I do think there's some questions that still need to be worked out.
Councilmember Ryan Crabb says he doesn't want the expanded center's events overlapping established attractions.
So we don't want one during Daytona 500. We don't want Bike Week. We don't want Biketoberfest. That, to me, is probably more important.
The city projects 450 overnight hotel stays every month as a result of the expanded center. For Flagler's Morning News, I'm Rich Petschke.
Matanzas High School is getting a new principal.
Superintendent Kathy Mittelstadt is recommending to the school board Kristen Bozeman. Mrs. Bozeman comes to Flagler Schools following a career in St. Johns County, where she was most recently the director of instructional personnel. She also served as a teacher, registrar, and assistant principal in St. Johns County. Superintendent Kathy Mittelstadt.
She is phenomenal. She is a rock star. She is curriculum and instruction minded, and she understands the programs that Matanzas High School has in play right now.
In addition, Kristen Bozeman cannot wait to arrive at the ship of her new position. She says, working with high school students is my passion, so I can't wait to meet the students, staff, and families that make up Pirate Nation. For Flagler's Morning News, I'm Karen Johnson.
What happened to the 4th of July?
It wasn't wiped off the calendar. We did not go from the 3rd of July to the 5th of July. Flagler Beach City Manager William Whitson said that he did his part.
I provided the commission with an opportunity to have fireworks, and it wasn't approved on a 3-2 vote.
Whitson said that the commission did not approve the new vendor.
All I can tell you is that after we figured out what was happening with the original proposal, we proposed several options, and at the end of the day, the fireworks contract with the new vendor wasn't approved.
He said that the only thing missing from the holiday was the fireworks show at Flagler Beach. Listen to the business report on WNZF on Saturday mornings at 10 or on the Flagler radio app. From the WNZF newsroom, I'm Deb Albertson.
The weekend is here and there's plenty of family fun going on in Flagler. This is Stacy with Fun for Augie Kids.
This afternoon, the Flagler County Public Library is hosting their Pixels and Purlers event. Kids in grades 6 through 12 can play Switch games such as Smash Brothers and Mario Kart and even create some of their own 8-bit art. Tomorrow, high school students in Flagler County are invited to join the Flagler County Junior Chamber of Commerce for their school cleanup project. This provides support for our public schools prior to the first day. Join Palm Coast Parks and Recreation for the Sports Alliance Youth Clinic. Sports offered will include baseball, basketball, flag football, and soccer, and this event is open to all Palm Coast residents aged 6 through 16. Join Michaels this weekend for their free in-store sensory demo featuring slime and their Make Break event featuring a You Belong Here collage poster. To learn more about these events and others, please visit us on our website at fun4augiekids.com. Have a great weekend.
And now you're up to date on Flagler's Morning News. I'm Rich Carroll.